California is building a river underground. Not a pipe, not a canal. A 72-kilometer-long water tunnel so massive, it's been called the largest water infrastructure project in state history. And the price tag? Over $20 billion. That's more than it costs to build 100 NFL stadiums. The goal? To move water from the wet north to the dry south, quietly, efficiently, and in a way that can survive earthquakes and climate change. But how exactly does it work? Why does it cost so much? And will it even solve the problem it's designed for? California has a water geography problem. Most of the rain and snow falls in the north, but most of the people live in the south. This imbalance has shaped California for nearly a century, driving huge engineering projects to redistribute water. The Central Valley Project in the 1930s and the State Water Project in the 1960s built massive dams, reservoirs, and canals to pump water south. But these systems are aging and vulnerable to seismic risk and climate extremes. Meanwhile, California's population and agriculture have only grown, increasing the pressure on a system that was already stretched thin. The Delta, where northern water converges before being sent south, has become a choke point. It's ecologically fragile, heavily managed, and central to the state's water lifeline. And that brings us to the tunnel. The idea of bypassing the Delta isn't new. Back in the 1960s, planners proposed the peripheral canal to route water around the Delta. Voters killed that idea in 1982, but the problem didn't go away. Over the decades, the idea kept coming back under different names: the Bay Delta Conservation Plan, the Water Fix, and now the Delta Conveyance Project. Each iteration faced the same core issue: how to move water without destroying the Delta's ecosystem. The Delta is home to endangered fish species and supports agriculture and communities that depend on its fragile balance. Any disruption could have massive ripple effects. The current plan involves two major water intake facilities on the Sacramento River, located near the towns of Hood and Cortland. These sites will gently draw water from the river using fish-friendly screens designed to prevent harm to aquatic life. Once the water enters the system, it travels through tunnels buried 30 to 40 meters underground. These tunnels bypass the Delta entirely, sending water directly south to a new pumping station near the Bethany Reservoir. The system is engineered to handle rising sea levels and rare but severe flooding events, making it one of the most climate-resilient water infrastructure projects ever attempted in the U.S. At the heart of the project is the tunnel itself, stretching 72 kilometers. That's about the length of the entire island of Manhattan. Four times over, it will be 11 meters in diameter. That's wide enough to fit three compact cars side by side. It will run deep underground, below seismic fault lines and sensitive wetlands, encased in watertight concrete to prevent leaks and ensure seismic safety. By going underground, the tunnel avoids disrupting the surface, which is critical for both environmental and logistical reasons. It's built not just for today's water needs, but for the unpredictable water realities of the next 100 years. The tunnel will be dug using earth pressure balance tunnel, boring machines, or TBMs. These massive machines can be longer than a football field and weigh thousands of tons. As they move forward, TBMs excavate soil while simultaneously installing precast concrete rings that form the tunnel wall. This method minimizes surface disruption, reduces noise and vibration, and is considered one of the safest and most efficient tunneling methods available. TBMs have been used in projects like London's Crossrail and the Gotthard Base Tunnel in Switzerland. For California's tunnel, they'll be adapted to deal with challenging geology, including clay, sand, and potential groundwater. Once the water exits the tunnel, it will be lifted into the Bethany Reservoir using powerful pumps. From there, it connects directly to the California Aqueduct, which carries water hundreds of miles south to cities and farms. Because the intake points are upstream from where saltwater intrusion is becoming a bigger problem, this system allows for quicker, cleaner water capture during rare but intense storm events. Timing is everything, and this system is designed to seize short-lived opportunities to move massive volumes of water. This tunnel is more than just plumbing. It's a climate adaptation tool. In early 2023, powerful storms dumped record amounts of rain on Northern California. Much of that water was lost to the ocean because the current system couldn't move it south fast enough. If the tunnel had existed, estimates suggest it could have delivered enough water to supply 3.3 million households for a year. In a future where droughts get longer and storms get more extreme, that kind of capacity could be critical. The project won't be built overnight. Construction is expected to last 14 years and generate over 5,000 jobs. There will be impacts, like over 200,000 heavy truck trips hauling equipment and materials. But the planning includes efforts to reduce noise, manage air quality, and avoid disruption to nearby communities as much as possible. Tunneling also helps reduce the project's surface footprint compared to open canals or other above-ground alternatives. At $20 billion, this is one of the most expensive infrastructure projects in California history. Some projections suggest it could go even higher once delays and inflation are factored in. Critics argue that the water it provides may not justify the cost, especially as California looks to diversify its water sources through recycling, conservation, and desalination. On the other hand, supporters say the tunnel is a critical backbone that makes other solutions more reliable. Without a stable conveyance system, none of the water from the north can get where it's needed. Governor Gavin Newsom has made the tunnel a key priority, pushing to fast-track environmental reviews and permitting. But it faces strong opposition from environmental groups, some local governments, and indigenous communities who say the project threatens ecosystems and ignores long-standing water rights. Lawsuits are ongoing. And while state agencies argue that delay means greater risk, critics warn of repeating the same mistakes that have plagued other mega projects. California's $20 billion tunnel is a bold bet on engineering, on climate prediction, and on the future of the state's water supply. It could safeguard millions of people against drought. Or it could be an overbuilt, overpriced gamble. What do you think? Is this smart infrastructure or a massive risk? Let us know in the comments. If you found this breakdown helpful, like the video, subscribe for more deep dives and hit the bell so you don't miss what's next.